We have two more questions. Question number two and question number three. We'll be solving these two questions in this video. And in question number two, we again have a universal set, and the two subsets are M and N. Q, B, Z, N, C, P belongs to set M, and Y, A, T, and then N, C, P belongs to N. These three members, S, K, E, does not belong to M and K. These all numbers are the part of a universal set, and the first question is basically M minus N. As we discussed in the difference operator, I told you that in the difference operator, we first cancel out the common elements. Since we are talking about M and N, so this is M, this is N, first we will cancel out the common elements. These three basically are the common elements, and then we will just look at the first bracket. The first bracket belongs to M. So the three members which are remaining after these common elements are Q, B and Z. So this will be the answer of M minus N, because in difference we first cancel out the common elements and then we just look at the first bracket, and in the first bracket these three are the only members which are remaining. So this these three are my answers. The next part is M intersection N. Intersection means common, and you know that this overlapping area basically tells us about the common. So N, C and P are the common elements of M and N, so the answer of M intersection N will be N, C and P. The third part is M union N whole complement, and we know that complement means other than, so we have to find the members which are other than M union N. M union N means, union means I have to combine all the elements of M and N, and since it is asking me for the complement, means I have to neglect all these, because I have to find all the numbers which are other than M union N. So what are the members which are other than M union N is basically S, K and E. So the answer of M union N whole complement will be S, K and E. The last part is M intersection N whole complement. M intersection N, first we will look at this M intersection N. Intersection means common, and we know that the answer of M intersection N is NCP. These three are the common elements between N and N. So since we have to find the complement, means other than these three, so other than these three will be Q, B and Z, Y, A and T and S, K and E. So this is the answer of basically M intersection N whole complement. In the next question, we have a universal set and two subsets K and L. In the first part, we are asked to find K complement union L. K complement union L. First, we will look at what does K complement tells us. What are the members of K complement? Complement means other than. So I have to look for the elements which are other than K. This is K basically, and other than K are 18, 20, 12 and basically 7. So 7, 12, 18 and 20 are the elements which are other than K. So the answer of K complement will be 18, 20, 7 and 12. Since I have to find the union with L, so I will be writing all the members of L also, because it is a union. In union, we combine the elements of both the sets. So the members of K complement is 18, 20, 12 and 7, and the member of L is all this 1, 10, 11, 18, 20. So I will write all these as the answer. 18, 20, 7, 12, 1, 10 and 11 will be the answer of K complement union L, because in union we have to write, we have to combine both the sets. This is L and these four are the answer of K complement. So I will just combine all of these. I will just write all of these as the answer. The next part is K intersection L. K intersection L means the common part, and the common part has 1, 10 and 11. So the answer of K intersection L is 1, 10 and 11. The next part is basically K union L complement, which is very much similar to the part one. But this time the complement is on L. So first I will see what are the elements of L complement. L complement means other than L. Other than L is 16, 8, 7 and 12. And since I have to find union again with K, so K means I have to write all five of these elements also. So what will I do? I will just make a curly bracket and I will just combine k that has 16, 8, 1, 10 and 11 and plus 7 and 12 also, because these four were the answer of L complement other than L, and these are the members of k since I have to combine both of them. So I will write all these as the answer. The last part is basically k minus L whole complement. Complement means other than k minus L. So I told you that in difference, we just have to cancel out the common elements and look at the first bracket. The first bracket belongs to k. So what are the members of k? 16 and 8. So since we are talking about k minus L whole complement, means we are talking about the members which are other than k minus L. So other than k minus L are all of these 1, 10, 11, 18, 20, 7 and 12. So these are the members which belongs to k minus L whole complement. So this was basically a different type of questions which can be asked under the heading of Venn diagram. I hope you have understood this question, and there will be some more problems on Venn diagram inshallah in the future. So stay tuned for the more videos on Venn diagrams, and if you have any query, you can use the comment box to describe your query, and inshallah I will be there to help you. Thank you very much.